And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Are you feeling the critical mass?
I feel a critical mass because I just ate that salad. Ah! Starting hot!
Is it all in you?
It's all in me.
Straight roughage.
Yeah,
is that poking on the door already?
It's roughage with Thousand Island dressing, so it's got some... It's got gas in the fireball.
I'd say you jumped in the dressings a little bit early, my friend, by what I sneaky peeked in there.
Oh, yeah?
In a little box we received today, which we're going to talk about later. It's The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. Big J. Okerson, that's Dan Soder.
Hi.
The whole crew is here joining us in the studio today. You know them, everyone. You love them. There's no need for introduction anymore. Yeah. People just say to throw him a third mic. It's Shane Gillis, everybody.
Yo.
Some call him the Thomas. He's the Benjamin Franklin of Sheets Nation.
I do declare.
He goes, I've traveled far, wide, Mechanicsburg, Harrisburg,
Shippensburg,
Ronsburg,
Stroudsburg,
Carlsburg.
Hell yeah,
we
dude.
We could spend 2 hours just naming all the Bergs of Pennsylvania.
Hey, fuck, it's the Ehrenbergs of
the
Pennsylvania.
People love, and we love when Shane Gillis is here, of course.
Yeah.
You came in on a day that we...
He moved the needle. The reason Shane's on the show today is because he fucking moved the needle, and he got us in touch. We got a styrofoam box of Sheets. Could this be an explosion? Maybe, if Sheets Nation really wants to strike at Wawa.
We haven't opened it, but lucky news, I have a lead vest. That was going to be my joke, but I look over the side of my eye and I see Christine CBD roll-awning loose temples. It's a fucking disturbing thing to watch.
For my peripheral, it looked like they were kissing.
It would have been less weird.
Yeah, if they're just tonguing, if they're just porn tonguing.
Let him roll it on his own face, you fucking grandma.
Yeah.
He's playing the board.
I got migraines. It's a real thing.
Yeah.
Migraines don't work with CBD oil applications, Christine.
It helped him yesterday. I let him use it, and it helped him, so he asked if he could use it again, and his fingers were busy on the board.
When did it help him yesterday? When?
He told me it did.
He's lying to you. He told me he had a crazy migraine the entire way home.
Also, Christine, the tone of your defense doesn't help with the grandma angle, because you're going, it was on the ride home. His head hurt.
He said it made him feel better.
Yeah.
Let Lou apply his own CBD. It's so weird looking.
Do you believe in migraine, Shane?
I'm going to start putting on Dan's lip gloss.
Oh, baby,
not lip gloss, your
chapstick?
Chapstick, yeah.
Deal.
I'm going to start putting it on you.
Heads up.
I'll always hold it for you, like when someone holds on to their friend's inhaler.
Yeah. I was watching, I talked about it on tomorrow's episode, but Hard Knocks, I didn't realize how many NFL players are like super into chapstick. It's like a thing.
There's a lot of black athletes.
No, this is Baker Mayfield, new quarterback, white dude.
Yeah, I know.
Rural boy.
But he's been hanging out playing with black guys for a long
so
time.
So that's why they all got LL Cool J lips?
Oh, my God. Let me tell you something. Nothing probably smells better than an NFL locker room, quite honestly. All the butters and creams in there, I bet it smells greasy as shit, though.
But then it's also white dude country. So it's like spit, like the smell of spitting of chew.
Chaw?
It doesn't smell.
It stinks like shit.
I dip in front of you all the time.
I've never smelled.
I have no sense of smell.
I've never, neither does Christine. What a weird thing to high five over. But okay.
Yeah, we can walk on piss trains. It's like we're superheroes.
Is that why you direct all of your farts directly at Christine? I'm always offended by it and she doesn't even know what's happening because she didn't hear it.
Well, it was supposed to be a fucking alpha move this entire time, but now that I know she can't smell.
Are you trying to conquer her?
I go, Jay's going home with her smelling like my butt.
I can't speak for the crew, but I will say there was a little bit of defeat in my heart. I felt a childlike, I mean, nothing to show because it didn't hit me that hard, but I was surprised at how in the car on the way home, I was like, oh man, I wanted to see that concert last night.
Oh, well, you got to, yeah.
We went, we did the live bonfires. I hope most of you heard.
Live from Jones
by
Beach.
By now, live from Northwell Health at Jones Beach Theater. For the Twins of Evil second coming tour, Rob Zombie, Marilyn Manson, sitting in our seats. The show went great. Sitting in our seats. Good seats. Big thank you to Don Wicklund at SiriusXM.
Yeah, really hooked it up.
For really taking care of us, and hopefully they'll get us the make-up date so we could go out there and do it again. I'd love to do a live broadcast again. And the live broadcast was really fun.
It
flew by.
A lot of fun people watching. I don't know, speaking of people watching, if you saw who was sitting in front of me, but it was Lou from the future. Did you see the guy in the Mets hat?
Oh, yeah, Future Lou?
Future Lou. Did you notice him, Lou?
No, because it sounds like you're insulting me.
No, not at all.
Notice him. He became him.
I was going to say, if you guys were in the same space, it would cause a ripple in the space-time continuum.
So the t-shirt I was wearing did make me look thin. I'm not thin.
Yeah, dude.
You look good, fat. Man.
You look super kissable, right, Shane?
Yeah.
Thanks, dude.
And I was saying when we were walking behind you in here that the shit hanging out of your back pocket's looking more and more ridiculous now that you're trimming down. Like a skinny guy. Now he looks like he's carrying a fucking rug everywhere.
Looks like that blanky,
like that kid from
Linus?
Snoopy.
Yeah,
swear to God. It was funny. Didn't wear it yesterday or the past couple days.
Yeah. I think you got to get rid of it, dude.
Saw it sitting there today and I was like, I really don't need it. Weighs my shit down. It's
now it's probably heavy as fuck for you.
And now I'm like, you know what? I'm already having a hard time keeping my pants up. That's not even so much weight loss. I just have no ass. Yeah. I'm a pants pull up all day guy.
I got no ass either, dude.
Are you same thing?
That Hank Hill ass.
Pants pull up flat all day long. I have to pull them up.
If I don't do it, I look like it looks like I'm sagging. It becomes sagging at one point.
Add a chain and, a carpet in the back pocket. No shit, man. Right. It does. It starts pulling down. And it freaks me out. I have to think ahead about if I'm holding a Starbucks and I'm going to smoke a cigarette, I'm like, I have to go somewhere where I can put the Starbucks down because one hand's going to have to keep hiking up my pants.
Yeah. How much pant breath do you get? How much after you pull up, what's the walking?
Am I walking?
Yeah, you're walking. Let's say we're walking from here to Fifth Avenue.
25 steps.
And then you got to pull up.
Something.
You got to pull up your banky in something. Your back pocket.
Sometimes I'll hold it. Sometimes I can walk wide-assed enough to hang them up by themselves a little bit. Also, by the way, I can go for like a, the heroin tourniquet on the belt, too, once in a while.
I thought you were saying you can jerk off.
I could just jerk off and then bone up, which is always going to hold them up.
That's going to really, that's a clothes hanger.
It's not a bad plan.
Yeah. You're going to coat hanger your jean shorts. With the bandana, could you just go right to skinny guy headband now? Just tie it around your head.
No, I would never do that. Bandana would go in the back pocket first.
Okay.
I'd lower.
You're going to lower it up? You're going to adjust it?
I'd make much smaller the back pocket accoutrement.
Okay. You're just going to do a nice fold and have it hang out?
It's possible.
All right.
I'm wearing a lot less wrist stuff these days.
Well, it's funny that Shane said that because Kurt did that joke at Moon Tower. Wasn't it Moon Tower? It was Moon Tower. He goes, my best friend is a big guy and he wears all this rock and roll stuff. And he's like, he's 40 pounds away from me being like, not my best friend anymore.
Yeah, he doesn't mind it when I'm fat, but if I lose weight, then that's like an asshole.
Yeah, he's like, if he's skinny, he's a dick.
But I would definitely, I'll never be thin. If I was thin.
You're not fat, though.
I don't know if my style of dress would be much different, but probably simpler.
Can I walk you over to the Dan Soder t-shirt and jean collection? You have a nice fun run.
I would if it was, I said, if I would do simpler.
Can we find
same sort of style, but a much simpler version of it. Same thing. I said, I don't wear t-shirts. I don't like the way I look in t-shirt. You know what I mean? I overthink everything, always.
Once you get the t-shirts, matching wrestling t-shirts.
Yesterday, though. Yeah. Oh, hell yeah. Just different tag. I'll be Jim the Anvil Neidhart. Bret Hart.
I'll wear a Marty Jannetty shirt if you want to wear a Shawn Michaels shirt.
I'll go. Well, you know what? Don't try to take that from me. You know Jannetty's the funnier of the two.
How dare you say that I'm just a handsome guy capable of a super kick?
You're trying to pull off...
I'll be Shawn Michaels all day. I'll find Jesus late in my career.
Trying to pull off irony, Dan. Just told me you were...
I'm a brunette.
Going on a break, and now I feel like you're trying to fucking big dick it again.
No, I hate you.
But I thought
about he has a big dick.
He does.
What?
No, I
you've been trotting around that apartment. Not
you didn't
let
even
me,
know it.
Not let me see that hog, dude.
Isn't that fucked up?
It? You're not letting.
Maybe it's
hog?
A Philly thing, but I see most of my friends' dicks at some point.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you who doesn't. Mike Vecchione, and he respects my non-penal seeing.
I saw Mike's dick once.
You
it's
did.
Gotta be a hammer, right?
Mm-hmm. I haven't seen it yet. I haven't seen it in 7 years.
We
towel up in the bathroom like
I don't remember being blown away by it. But just keep in mind, I've seen Kevin Hart's dick, and that's like ridiculous.
It's got to look like that thing hanging out of your back pocket.
Yeah, it really does. It looks like he's carrying a carpet.
Yeah.
It looks like you walking backwards.
He just shifted it forward.
I don't even know if I ever saw it hard, but just even soft, it was like, it's a real, like, hey, let's play strip poker, or let's, you know what I mean? Like
you lead with it.
It's a big...
You're trying to show people it. You walk people there.
Yeah.
It's that kind of dick. That's what I'm saying.
Yes, without a doubt.
It's one of those dicks where you're like, oh, no, come to me.
He said to me...
I'm not a real
go-to-you
guy.
He said the words in my ear before when we had girls hanging out in a hotel room. He said the words to me. He goes, dare me to take out my dick.
Dude, wow.
And then I go, okay, Kev, pull
that's
out your
like
dick.
When someone can play the guitar and they go, hey, lead me in. I'll get there. You're like, this guy fucking what?
Wait, this is great.
Yeah, that's a real shred move.
I go, Kev, pull out your dick, and I swear to you, he dropped it on the end table.
Oh,
it
man.
Made a good thud.
My dick has never hit a table.
And then he goes, and then the you know, it was like black chick, so it was like the girls were like, wow, that's good. And then Jay goes, where Kev goes, Jay, I dare you to pull your dick out now. Thinking like he's hooking me up, and I was like, dude, this is nuts.
You go, I'm Christian. You just find religion in that moment to get
it's
out
just
of it.
Like,
I love
especially
God.
Then, I'm not going to pull it out.
He goes, no, Jay, now you break the table. You go, oh, man, I don't know.
He goes, should we double it up and just bend this fucking metal in half?
Yeah, you go, I don't
know.
Oh,
Kev, no.
Oh, yeah, good. What?
Oh, man, dude.
I would be such an energetic comic if I had that big of a dick. I'd be like, watch it jiggle.
Look at that thing's mean. He's 5'3".
Yeah. Good. You know, God.
And by the way, it's here's what's happening. But go back to that for a second.
He clearly just made a video for his dick on YouTube.
Yeah, that was,
yeah,
no,
sure.
It was his birthday.
Just
video.
For that.
It was a birthday for his dick.
Lil Kev, dude.
Hang on. Hang on. Stop it. Where it's in the middle. God damn it. Now, what I want you to see is it's barring across the entire area where even dick would start. So that means what's happening is half of it's folded over onto itself.
Yeah.
So it's like take half that dick and flip it out. That's the whole soft dick.
Yeah.
And then that gets hard.
That's crazy. Well, it's also with this underwear, it seems like the dick is inconvenienced. Like
a
normal sized dick goes right into the pocket and it's fine. This dick's like trying to get through something and it's like move.
Yeah, it looks
we have a straw. I want to demonstrate what I'm talking about so you can see exactly.
Are we
what
doing
I'm
bonfire dick science again?
Yeah, yeah.
Welcome.
Give me that leather case right there.
This
is perfect. This is gonna be my soft dick.
All right.
Now I'm gonna roll it up.
Okay.
In the soft dick.
This
right now,
looks
okay?
Like you're about to do a trick.
Okay.
And now a dildo.
Yeah. Give me your watch.
Yeah. I'm gonna tear this 20.
This is his soft dick. What you're seeing, but. It's going too far across. That means what's actually happening is...
That's not true.
That's what's happening with his dick.
No.
Yes!
That's not a fold.
Am I wrong, Black Lou? Look where his dick... His dick starts somewhere way up too high and to the left or way too low and to the right.
I completely agree.
Oh, my God. Really?
Yeah, part of that's bent over itself.
Fuck you for ever saying I have a big dick. If that's what I'm fucking...
Yeah, you've been hanging around these?
No, but that's like a fucking mythical dick.
Mythical dick.
You got a big old hog and you're white? Come on.
Well,
don't make me throw this at you.
Black, naked, big, long, cock, everything.
She was right. At the end of the day,
right.
She was right.
So you would lead him to that, then he would try to get you to pull your dick out. Mm-hmm. Which is, come on. I mean, there's no one...
Two or three times.
I don't think
times.
There's anyone on the floor right now that in this whole entire level of this building that could compete with that.
Two or three times.
The camera guy just starts snickering.
No, that's not true. That's not true. Yeah. This is a big dick.
Didn't know I was coming to a Boy Scout meeting.
Love the title of this YouTube video.
Yeah, Kevin Hart shows off his workout skills and dick in his new Tommy John. Yeah, he also like part owner of Tommy John.
Well, I would too. Tommy John clings to you. I feel good about my dick and Tommy John.
And here's the good
news.
And
I don't have a Hercules dick.
I like my dick and Tommy John's too. And I'll tell you this. Material is very thin, and the thing is, as an owner, every time your big fat dick breaks through the material,
break on through to the other side.
I keep finding myself looking at the camera at the weirdest times to say, if you find your dick breaking through, then you know.
Dick it.
Sorry, guys, I ham when the cameras are on. Anyway, to go back to the thing I was feeling, I think in the pictures I look okay in some of those, in that particular t-shirt. But we went to the show, we did the show.
Yeah.
As we're sitting in our seats, is where we were, when we saw Lou, and Lou, future Lou in front of us.
Looper Lou.
The stage set looked awesome.
It's not a disrespectful comment.
Stage set looked awesome. Two big banners of Marilyn Manson, like in a suit, holding a gun, his face is half-pimpered. Like, really cool, silhouette-y looking stage set, and you hear a voice go, ladies and gentlemen, and this is... The second time I've ever heard an announcement made at a concert, ever. The crowds, both times, very stupidly, start cheering for an announcement's not good.
At a concert?
Yeah.
Never.
And the first time I heard an announcement was, we're waiting for Black Sabbath to come on at Ozfest. Everyone, I'm so goes, I have a message here from Ozzy Osbourne, and the crowd goes,
And oh, you're man!
Still, and you're just looking around like idiots. Yeah. This is clearly him. Because it was a tour where he was missing some dates and he wasn't very like healthy or whatever.
So when they read that at Ozfest, what did he cancel?
Yeah.
That's great.
He canceled at Ozfest.
He goes, Ozzy is right now! He's coming out early! He's like, oh,
by the way, here's the weird thing that happened.
I bought everyone in here Lotto tickets.
I may have said this before on the show. He goes, my good friend, it was Judas Priest, Judas Priest, Black Sabbath on that one. Okay. That was the main two bands. And he goes, but my good friend Rob Halford of Judas Priest has agreed to front Black Sabbath tonight and do double duty. And then almost everybody left.
Really?
And I sat there and watched Rob Halford do, it was insane.
Yeah.
By the way, the most gracious thing I've ever seen, or he was, I met him briefly at Goddamn Comedy Jam. Was not very friendly. He was not very friendly, huh?
Yeah. I said, yeah, but I mean,
yes, flamboyant gay from the '80s. Yeah. Yes, Rob Halford. Yeah,
he's
gonna be nicer.
He's
catty. Definitely gonna be mean.
Yeah,
he's the meanest guys on earth.
Yeah, he's gonna be like this.
They went through the shit.
Yeah, he goes, I'm bathhouse generation.
He's back in a band he got kicked out of too.
Oh yeah,
but it was the most gracious thing. Where after every song, he'd be like a new thing where he's like. You know, it's amazing, too. It's my birthday.
Oh, Jesus.
He goes, so what a birthday present to get to be the front man for one night of the greatest heavy metal band in history. You know,
and there's six people.
Hey, yeah, it's me. It's like, yeah, Rob.
Hey, Big J. Okerson, big fan.
Do it.
Keep doing it, dude.
Not gay. If I was, I'd do something to you.
Oh, I swear to God, you're my style, too. A lot of leather play. I
give
that.
You something.
Yeah. And you just fucking.
If he holds the rug in my back pocket, it means he's my bitch.
He goes, also, if people are leaving, he's like, I lost my dog yesterday.
Yeah, he goes, the only thing that could possibly cheer me up is performing with Black Sabbath.
I lost me pop crazy train. That's how much I love Sabbath, and you're all leaving on my birthday.
On the eve of the death of crazy train.
I'm not going to be able to perform tonight because I would rather have my friend Rob Halford perform. Fuck you, man! Dude, that's so fucking funny.
I will say, in fairness, when the announcement started yesterday, I did think there were... Like, Marilyn Manson would do... One of his... tours I saw, a voice came over. I don't count it as an announcement because it wasn't, but it was just a voice of God thing. It was like, everybody, Omega and the Mechanical Animals. It was Mechanical Animals tour when he came out with the tits and shit.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, there's like an announcer that almost like it was a variety show opening.
Yeah.
His openings were always the best. So like, I thought it might be, but it was like, ladies and gentlemen, he goes, because of the imminent storm, we're going to be taking a quick delay until the storm passes, so everyone go get cover, please, out by the concourse, and we'll start the concert and perform it in its entirety.
We will resume the show in its entirety as soon as safely possible.
And it's great to hear that New York accent, that Long Island accent, where they
possible.
Go, listen, honestly, it's about to get mad wet. And I know you guys all like your makeup, and you're all queers, so maybe want to hide under this, you know, the structure. Anyways, Frank Sinatra.
I don't want you lady boys.
Yeah, I'll tell you this right now. If it was a real class act, they'd play in the ring. But anyways, come back in when it ain't all wet.
But he, so we went out and waited, and it came down. When it came... It came
Dude,
hard.
You saw it move. The sky went from like blue, and then it was like I was jokingly like, oh, look at this, and it went like purple. Like that's how dark it got. But I swear to God, Jacob doesn't get enough credit for how funny he is because he's also insane, and no one talks about this. But Jacob's slightly an insane person, and we're walking to the shelter, and Jacob's going, please take cover. Satan doesn't want you to get wet. He's just saying these things to himself, cracking my shit up. And we were just, I just heard him doing it. I was like, that's so goddamn funny.
Jacob, did you get fucked up?
No.
You were probably fucked up at this, weren't you?
You know it, man.
Yeah, he's a bad boy.
He's a real bad boy. He kept giving his metal horns when we were waiting for the rain.
What type of music do you listen to? What do you listen to?
Podcasts.
No, I love metal. I love Iron Maiden, Metallica.
Oh, really?
This was going to be my first Manson. And
no, he would have loved it. We're doing the makeup. Shit. We're doing the makeup.
I'm going. I'm not on the road.
It's going to be fun. It's going to be fun. We're going to plan it so no one's on the road. We're going to do this thing. We waited for the when it came hard, but that part did pass. So it was an annoying head fake on a steady to light to back to steady, like, rain.
It was doing this. It was every 5 minutes. You're like, all right, they're gonna start this bitch up.
Yeah, and then the problem was, it never stopped lightning.
That was a good lightning.
Ever.
I looked at you. I was like, damn, that was good, dude. That's a good noise you made.
It was never not lightning.
You can see how serious the storm was when it was coming by the Instagram video you guys posted.
Yeah.
You can see how scared Dan actually is.
I was like,
it's a real storm, dude.
Well, a pond? Do we have to get in the cellar?
I'll tell you what, friend of the show, Matt Brown, the comic, moved up here from Baltimore.
Oh, I know Matt.
Matt's a good kid. He came to the...
He said he wants to fight you. It was crazy.
Fuck him up.
Dude, I know. I just didn't want to bring that up.
He came to the show yesterday and, like, I felt bad. Like, the people that did end up getting the tickets, like, winning the tickets we had to offer. For like everyone just sort of standing there, like it's going to go away. But I learned about him though. That was exciting for me. Was I just said out loud? I was like, man, this storm, especially standing like 15 feet from it or whatever as we were. I was like, when I was a kid, this would have sent me into like you might have to take me to a hospital for a seizure. I'd be so afraid of this. And he was like, oh yeah, me too. The only other person I heard that said they were afraid of weather also as a kid. Terrified of bad weather.
And after they said that,
I thought it was always the end of the world each time.
I snickered and walked away. I went, oh cool. I thought it was Radio Partners with a Man. I didn't realize I was,
what are you, a wet chihuahua? You saw, I'm okay now.
Oh yeah, that's because Christine clamped on your thunder vest. She goes, here you go. I got to clamp them down.
You guys can tell I was holding my emotional parrot.
I bet there was a...
He goes, what?
I bet there was a...
Storm's coming!
That was you, dude.
Yeah. Dude, Shane, did you not know I do voices and noises?
Whoa.
I'm Dan Soder, voices and noises.
Yo, man, get in front of me. You weirded me out with that.
Hey, man, I really thought there was a pair loose in here. It's kind of fucking my shit up. But no, Jay, I didn't know that it was that serious. I didn't know people were afraid of the weather that much. Like that. Because when I was a kid, I was always like, yeah, take me away.
You scream at you like Lieutenant Dan.
Yeah. Bring it on! I sit on the roof of my mom's house going, take me! I'll see you back there!
You're holding the antenna for the TV.
Come on, you motherfucker! Give me my powers! But I didn't know you were afraid. You could
terrified.
Be like, terrified.
I mean, my dad, this might explain a little bit of the deadbeat dad thing.
Why he left you? He goes, I can't raise a son. I can't sire a child that's afraid of fighting.
I'm not lying. He wasn't around enough, so when he would get me, he would get whatever my... living with Jewish women is done to me. So then I'd go there. And I'd be everything. I'd be nervous about everything and scared. And then rain would come. So we went. He goes up. He goes,
like, oh, God, it's going to rain and ruin the whole day.
My poor dad, for something, was just like, all right, well, I feel bad because I'm taking my stepkids, so I guess I got to take this little Fanuc with me to... I got to take him to Florida, I guess, with me for Disney World. Dude, we were in Disney World for an hour, and it's Florida.
Yeah, so it rains all the time.
And then stops.
Yeah.
You'd be fine. If that one rain, I mean, probably borderline close to, like, rolling on the back and rolling on the ground.
No!
And by the way, we have the pictures of me I sent you.
Yeah, for first grade.
That you're going to hear us mention tomorrow that dude, we're going to show you
there's just something,
here in a minute.
There's something so funny about both of our dads just rejecting us and being like, oh, God, these ones. We're like, it's storming, Father! Storming! And he goes,
this kid is a real cranberry sauce.
How's he supposed to be the heir to the Okerson lightning rod fortune? He goes, he's afraid of storms.
Yeah, Jewish lightning.
Yeah, the Jewish lightning.
He called me Jewish lightning. Because even that fat, I was still the fastest Jew in the neighborhood.
So fast, so quick, agile. Dude, that's so goddamn funny. Do you have the pictures of him in first grade?
In fact, for some of my youth, when the neighbor was mostly Jewish, it was funny to find out what level of athletics you'd think kids could be.
Yeah.
Because you got the best Jewish athletes. And then, that's what's so weird, when I turned like 13, I guess it was, or so, and we started going to the Jewish Community Center, and then Lower Marion kids were played there too.
Yeah.
That's what Kobe Bryant saw. Dude, I saw Kobe Bryant and his friend Rory, I believe his name was, 14 years old. I would just be like, they have powers.
Yeah.
I'm like, human beings can't jump that high.
You were just isolated from black athletes until you were 13?
No. I wasn't really, except for there was no organized sports in my thing. So it was pickup games.
Okay.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And like the neighbor, we'd play by like my house with my friend. You know what I mean? And it was like there was always black and white kids there for the most part. But like, I'm trying to think of a good way to put this. We speak tomorrow about my friend Randy Relaford, who I came up to.
Yeah.
But Randy Relaford wasn't like you'd think, like the slam dunk kid. You know, he was like a smart kid, academic stuff. You
Johnny
know what I mean?
Johnny Jones was his best athlete.
Best athlete.
Yeah, yeah.
Wait, oh, did you just describe a black dude as not slam dunk type? Did I hear that, or am I fucked up?
Well, I mean, that's, I mean, I think you, I thought that was your guys' Philly code.
He's like, yeah, they don't slam dunk or nothing, but he's a different type of black, you know, the ones that don't slam dunk.
It's either a slam dunk or a Hail Mary. Yeah, he ain't a Hail Mary.
Yeah, was he a dunker or thinker?
Yeah. He's more of a coach than he is, not even like a player coach. Like, oh, dude, that's fucking...
No, he still had the extra bone. I'm not saying he wasn't athletic.
He's Jimmy the Greek in a way.
I'm not saying that at all. No, and I'm saying I did play with black kids. I'm just saying...
But you're saying Laura Marion, that's the first time that you were like...
That Kobe Bryant was the first time you saw somebody at that level. Yeah. I guess what I'm saying,
well,
these are kids...
It's Kobe Bryant!
Because my neighborhood, younger than 13, but went pretty like half and half black and Jewish, but... And then the Italian kids from down the hill. You just saw a lot of like...
They're playing baseball.
Yeah, but you just saw a lot of like white... Wise. I saw a lot of white kid athletics, and these kids who grew up in a neighborhood... Listen, to the black kids, they were like, oh, shit, I grew up in a half-Jewish neighborhood.
Yeah.
So they had the influence of that. So everyone kind of got like...
Like, I love conditions. Yeah.
The good guys were the good guys, black and white. You know what I mean? The guys who were like mid-level good at any sports like me was black and white kids, too.
What's funny is you going from the JCC to Kobe Bryant.
To Kobe Bryant. That's what it is. Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, one of the greatest basketball players, if not the, well, top three? Top five?
Black Mamba? Well, you know, yes. Allen Iverson.
There's people that are punching
their
steering
wheel. And then Allen Iverson, then Allen Iverson when he came back to the Sixers, and then Kobe Bryant.
I go LaPhonso Ellis, Chauncey Billups.
Chauncey Billups.
Dikembe Mutombo, Chauncey Billups. You really round it out.
Dude, the JCC is... So you played for the JCC?
No, not for them. That's where we just go after school and play there.
Oh, all right.
You could just play. It was like a rec center, but it happened to be like the JCC.
Did they have a team? The Chosen Ones? We have fun.
The 6 points?
But I was wondering if you guys got... Because my Catholic team played against the JCC.
Blood in the water this Saturday.
If we started to lose, things got anti-Semitic. Just
really?
Right away, dude.
Really?
Yeah, be like, yeah, well, you're a fucking Jew anyway. Like, immediately you just...
You guys got school ties on them the second you started fucking losing?
Because no one's going to come down on you for it.
Yeah.
No one's going to come down on you for it. You can just walk away from that one.
Our priest actually... All right, well, this is probably not the best story. Yeah. But, yeah, our priest actually did. He was like, were you guys saying shit like that? Because I guess they had a little chat with him.
He goes, the rabbi coach? Yeah. It's just the rabbi is their coach? Since you guys have a priest, they have a rabbi? He's like, what are you doing? That is he was saying stuff about our kids right to their faces.
And this fishnicket kid comes up and tells one of my boys.
He goes, the priest just goes, you know what, this is, I should have a private consultation with this player. You're absolutely right.
Yeah. He kept saying, take a long kike ride. And I knew what he was messing it up on Pipus. I knew on Pipus he was messing it up.
Pipus.
That kid came in with a very stiff Pipus. Yeah. Make these Jewish kids feel bad about Judaism.
Can we see Jay in first grade? Mm-hmm. I want to see JCCJ.
Goddamn right you do.
He's a lightning storm.
Well, not first grade wouldn't be JCC.
No.
For camp, though.
For camp?
Yeah.
Man, I went to camp. I went to a Christian summer camp, and that is spooky.
Hey.
Good Lord, dude.
What do you mean by that?
It's creepy.
Oh.
So many of them could be Jay.
Yeah. Well, here's what I'm going to show you. I told you yesterday about when my dad met my mom.
You look at that chick in the middle.
I told you.
Like, damn, dude, Jay's crazy.
Dude, I swear to you, I saw this picture. I was like, they're going to make that thing.
Jay's overall game is crazy.
Are those frills?
Yeah. Is Jay Freddie Mercury?
Oh, guys, I'm sorry. First grade, I didn't tell you guys I was Ziggy Stardust all year.
That was a big Bowie year for me. It was first grade.
But where were the spiders? I took a picture of this wide to show you Mrs. Chernoff, who I tell you about tomorrow.
Oh, yeah,
on the show.
Lived across the street from your grandma. Real psychopath.
Her daughter was my mom's friend, and my dad porked my mom when he met...
where are you?
When she met my dad, when she was hanging out with her daughter.
Where are you?
I always knew that.
Beautiful son of a bitch. By the way, we've referenced the cameras and the lighting. They're filming. We're getting a video element to this show.
I want to say something that's weird right now about a first grader. All the way to the right, the top, like second row.
Me?
Yeah, her right there.
Yeah.
Jill Neff Weird. Hairy armpits girl brought in a bucket of eyeballs to school for science fair. Still bet she grew up hot.
Wait,
like I bet she grew up. When she was out of school, she was the one where you were like, I should jump on this ground level because I'm telling you, when she blows up, it's going to be a big come around for her because she's hot and she's just like one of those.
Just bucket of eyeballs.
What kind of eyeballs? Like cow eyeballs?
Yeah.
Oh, thank God. I didn't know.
She was going to grow into her nose. And I'm telling you, it was all going to be, it was going to be smooth sailing. Someone got a hot chick. I've looked for her on the internet and I can't find her.
Is this first grade Jay assessing her? Going, this is some talent.
Well, she would, no, here's the thing. My school was, I left to go to Ohio with my dad's for like half a year.
Yeah.
But I came back to it. My school, and then in 11th grade, I moved to South Jersey.
Yeah.
But my school's kindergarten through 12th grade. So the reason,
really?
I can tell you the names of almost anybody in this picture.
You get to watch them grow.
Because I know all these people.
So it's K through 12, you never change schools. You just go to a different part of the school.
Unless you got like, you know, if they put you in like the slower classes, like behind or the remedial.
I get that.
Or whatever.
But ours went to like 5th grade, then you went to a middle school from 6th to 8th, and then you went to a high school from 9 to 12.
By the way, swear to you, by chance, didn't even know this, because I brought these names up to you. I'm on the bottom, middle. That's me.
Yeah.
But more than that, flanked on either side, go to the left.
Yeah.
Randy Relaford.
Yeah.
Go to the right. Randy Hankin.
Randy Hankin. The Randy Hankin.
I said all these names to you.
Dude, get down there. I want to see
you. There,
oh, boy.
I am.
Yeah, buddy. What a little cutie.
I didn't care about teeth. Who needs them?
Fucking. You look like you're saying something. Like, it looks like you're doing crowd work to the photographer. Hey, can
hey, what's up, guy?
You ever?
It's probably your name, right, guy?
Hey, you ever sat on your hand and jerked off? The guy's like, kid, can you? can you angle your head like this? And you go, yeah, nah, I ain't got teeth.
Hey, you ever?
It looks like you're talking.
You ever take a bath and then you let your little your pee head get above the water and you go periscope up?
Yeah.
You ever do that? I bet this guy does that. Am I right or am I right?
First grade crowd work. You go. You ever? Hey, you ever piss your pants and there's a lightning storm?
I'm just fucking with you. Laser background, please.
Yeah. He goes, are we going to do the face and face? Do you want to give me forward face and I'll go side face?
So you can pump me up here. Ghost of me above me.
He goes, what are we doing here? Are we working laser background?
Dude, I always wanted the sick backgrounds and I never got them.
Dude,
I
got them and they suck
family.
Every time.
I always got gray backgrounds. Check all my photos.
Weak backgrounds.
Gray backgrounds.
They let me kind of, I'd want like laser. And then you realize as you get older how stupid laser is. I'll always forget. Regret that somewhere in the world. I gave Kurt because it made him laugh so hard when we first met. I had found an old
gray
picture.
Background. It's always gray background.
Yeah. I'd found a picture of me like more awkward, like at being like 13 or 14. Really funny.
I'll try to have Trish send me the picture from when I was in second grade.
If anyone listens to the show, went to school with me or anything, and you have pictures you can send, please, God. Yeah. Please, God, send. My life.
That was senior year, dog. Oh,
no. Do you want to hear a real sad thought I had?
Yeah.
Talk about the darkness of somebody. When I saw a sitcom intro a couple years back, and actually got bummed out thinking about that, and it was a show that they use in the beginning. Several shows did this for a while. They'd use like several pictures of the person, like, you know, baby, family ties, did it, growing pains did it at one point. It showed like actual childhood pictures of the person. And
of
I was
the
like,
actors?
If I got a part on a show and they go, all right, I need you to gather up some pictures from your past so you can show a montage of your life growing up. I'm like, no one really took pictures of me growing up. I don't know. I just don't have a picture.
You don't have school pictures?
School pictures,
but
maybe.
I don't have school pictures. I don't have, like, there's like maybe birthday parties
occasionally. No, there's got to be some candids you doing whippets with a guy outside of a fucking Circle K.
Oh, man. Those kids definitely didn't have cameras on.
Like you light up, you go, oh, man, a catalog.
Yeah, I got a whole book, a photo book. No, but I want to find, because Trish was always, this was like the definition of, I didn't tell her that it was picture day because I wanted to wear my Simpsons shirt. And we went, and it was my second grade picture or third grade picture, and it's like an orange shirt with the Simpsons on the front, and my hair is just, I just woke up and went to school. It was one of those, and I'm like, is my mouth open? I'm like, and my dumb gap in my teeth, I'm like, and dude, my mom, Life Touch, that was the company that did them.
Always.
Always. When my mom.
And then what was the one that did your ring?
Oh, I didn't get a ring.
No, what was it? Jostens something?
It was, I know, the catalog.
Jostens?
That was like the yellow catalog they handed out. But my mom opened the Life Touch photo and furious. Like, 0 to 60 Trish, because she's just like, what the fuck? She goes, what the fuck is this, Daniel? And I was like, because I went by Daniel till sixth grade. He's like, suck my dick.
Wow, you really got defensive. I didn't even say anything bad.
That was
about
a few. That was for Twitter. That was when I check into my study. And
yeah, I had
goes,
it. So what?
Yeah. But she goes, Daniel, what the fuck is this? And she's like, you got to do retakes. Because there was retakes, you know, for the kids that couldn't afford it or the kids like me that purposely mm-hmm. fucked it up. And then she put me in this fucking tight ass golf shirt and got me a dorky ass haircut. I think I've Instagrammed that picture before.
Hey, could we?
That was a makeup day.
You think, Dan, it would be possible for us to, I'll put this out there to the group, could we have a picture day at the bonfire?
Yes.
Can we hire dude, Life Touch to come in and really backdrop us and stuff?
Fucking,
can I get laser?
Yes.
Hey, buddy.
No.
By the way.
Yes, you can get laser.
That's
just shut you down and goes, no.
Hey,
no, what am I, made of money, asshole?
That's makeup.
I get it, dude. I totally get it.
Oh, shit.
That was the makeup day.
Dan. It looks like your hair's not actually... that looks like the scene... Remember the scene? Was that Tommy Boy or Black Sheep where his hair blows? Or you find out that David Spade's hair...
It's the end of Tommy Boy. Yeah.
That's what you look like there.
My five head?
Dude, you look like Ed Grimley.
Fucking huge.
Yeah, dude. Big head.
That's a big forehead.
By the way, though, can I show...
You grew into your head, though.
You really did. Yeah. You give yourself too much shit for your head now.
No, because I'm still this kid. Because growing up, everyone was like... Jesus Christ, people would react.
He goes, why is that upside down why is that upside down raindrop wearing?
Yeah. Go, oh my God, someone put a fucking boy's body on that ram's head.
You look like Mr. Mackey, dude.
Yeah. I'm like, okay. Yeah, I don't know.
Dude, yikes.
Here's the real, I swear to God, this is a real thing. Me putting my head through that shirt hurt. I remember
that. Your forehead is bigger than an iPhone 7 Plus.
I remember specifically being like, ah! My nose, just pulling down my nose. It hurts so bad.
Good Lord.
Yeah, I know. You think? Why do you think Trisha's got such an attitude?
It looks like
she gave birth to a watermelon with a body on.
Dan, you are a very handsome man. I'm telling you that.
Thank
because
you.
It does look like you were born near power lines or something.
Yeah. Look, it's a fucking.
Although I was not a good looking kid myself. Yeah. I'm not throwing stones here.
If you, dude, the one joke I told you that I made to my mom that she got upset about was I made a fetal alcohol syndrome joke, and she got upset to the point that I was like, was that a fucking thing? Like, did I battle out of FAS as a child?
You just swing
through
it.
You see pictures like that. But what I was saying is the picture where I'm wearing the Simpsons shirt and I have longer hair and it's matted down on one side because I was sleeping on it. But then it's like, and it doesn't look as terrible. For some reason, this picture came out twice as worse with that tight ass golf shirt on. I was like, man, this is terrible.
No, if you have any mental retardation, they won't do LASIK on you.
Well, they did it and they zapped away. The learning disability.
He goes,
learning disability.
Guys, it's great news. He goes, I'm not dyslexic anymore. And I can see.
I can see you making fun of me from across the room.
Yeah. I don't know what we should do. I have crack baby teeth. It's 6:40.
Yeah, we got to take our break.
Should we take our break and then we have to come back? Yeah.
And then we got to come back with this box.
We got to jam out the sheets box because.
Yeah, Shane's got to get out of here.
Absolutely. So we're hanging out with Shane Gillis, everybody. It's the bonfire. Hey, campers, we all know you're never going to get as much sleep as you want, so you have to make every hour of sleep you get count. Bowl and Branch is going to help you finally get what you really deserve, a great night's sleep with a set of their 100% organic.
Oh, that's
their 100% organic cotton sheets. Yeah, I crawled into these last night, sad, and they did make me feel better.
You know what, man?
And I did sleep great, actually.
But you said something yesterday where you keep being like, yeah, dude, it gets softer with time, and now I'm just going to keep bothering Jacob until I get my Bowling Branch.
Yeah, go at him about it.
Size queen. Queen size.
They're twice the quality of other luxury sheets for half the price. Join the hundreds of thousands of Americans, including 3 U.S. presidents. Impressed much?
I mean...
I'm throwing it at you, Shane. 3 U.S. presidents.
Jimmy Carter.
Guess the other two.
Trump.
Yes.
Yeah. And?
W.
Yes.
Yes.
No, I don't know.
But it is fun to watch someone think they're really smart and nailed it.
Whoa!
No. We don't tell us that.
You will love these sheets, and they know you will so much that you can try them in your home risk-free for a month. Bowl & Branch's award-winning blankets, towels, and pillows that are all just as comfy as their classic sheets. So order today and get $50 off your first set of sheets with promo code BONFIRE. That's $50 off at bowlandbranch.com with promo code BONFIRE, spelled B-O-L-L and branch.com slash, well, sorry, promo code BONFIRE.
Time! Oh, I've got dinner plans for you, Jay. But guess what? It doesn't involve a restaurant.
What?
Or an order.
Oh.
Or even food. The dinner is knowledge. Actually,
not this time.
Yeah. I'm talking about HelloFresh.com. HelloFresh are prepared, delicious home-cooked meals that they deliver to you in pre-measured ingredients, delivered right to your front door. And it's the perfect amount for the recipe. One pot recipes.
Well, several of them. They're not recipes, but they're all different really recipes. Easy.
Yeah, you go. Just go to HelloFresh.com and you can sign up. You go and you choose from a variety of recipes from veggie, classic, family plan, and then your meals arrive with easy to follow instructions.
Easier to follow than this read.
Yeah, that's for damn sure. With all these color pictures. Listen, I'm an idiot. If I'm going to cook something, you need to walk me through it step by step and hand me the ingredients. And that's basically what HelloFresh does.
They do. And you have to throw out almost nothing.
Yeah. And then,
because they give you, it's measured for you. It's pretty foolproof.
Yeah. And it's a one pot recipe. So it's one pot recipes for all your speedy cooking needs. All you got to do is go to HelloFresh.com/comedy, and you're going to get $30 off your first box, plus free shipping. It's pretty awesome. HelloFresh.com/comedy for $30 off. That's HelloFresh.com/comedy. Start eating good stuff for once. Dan. Okay, Dan.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Killed the Kennedys and Huxley too. Well, I'm sorry, Shakespeare was your scapegoat, and your apple sticking into my throat. Sorry, your son who smiles or busted nails in your crucifixion commercials failed. But I'm just a bit of fun, anonymous.
Doing Manson B-sides today because I just want to listen to some Manson now.
I get it, man.
If you listen on the way home. I've been a bit of a hole, Manson hole, past couple hours.
Are you one of those people that listens to music up to the concert or after the concert? Like, I like to listen
after.
Yeah. Okay.
After, I might go back and listen to something. Yeah, but like, no, not going. I never understand that. I listen to music going to it, but I'd almost rather listen to music way opposite of what I'm going to hear.
Yeah, so that you're surprised.
I'd rather listen to like 80s pop on the way to Marilyn Manson if I had a choice, yeah.
So that way when you see it, you're like, yeah, all right.
I never listened to Marilyn Manson.
Yeah. At all?
No, but it's funny because I was just thinking all the kids I bullied in high school definitely did.
Yeah.
Like, if I would like push him and be like, yo, you're fucking gay, dude. And I'd push him, and then he would go out in his car and blast this. And be like, fucking dickhead.
He goes, I'm going to come back and get Shane. I'm going to get Shane. That's funny if you're like, wait, hold on. Let me shut my eyes. Jacob, let me push you. He goes, I know this song.
Listen, I don't think video games as music should ever be to blame for terrible things. I don't believe anything.
No, of course
it's stupid.
Not.
It's art. But that said, it's ridiculous. Again, I've been listening to a lot of songs lately. These are all songs to, like, this is the stuff I was listening to, and I tell you, I squeezed my Starbucks cup thing. It's like, you're just like, that. This is very angsty music,
yeah,
and then the lyrics are pretty dead on. It's very like Red Dragon shit, some of the music. It's not only it's like, you've been fucking with me, and now I'm going to be like a fucking monster.
Yeah.
It's like a lot of that shit, which is awesome. I still, at 40 years old, want to get all of his lyrics tattooed on me. I got to stop myself. Daily.
You're like, that's daily. Another one. Another sentence.
I'm telling
another
you.
Sentence.
Oh, fuck yeah, dude. What did I say to you when I came in?
Oh, from the lyric?
Oh, yeah. Go, Christine, go to Antichrist Superstar. No, go to Antichrist Superstar. Like, not lyrics. I don't need the lyrics. Just go to the end of the song. Just freak, let's say they freaked Lou out in the car.
Yeah, you were saying that he plays extra voices.
Yeah, it's just such weird, eerie shit.
And
let's see when Christine gets it up here.
Sorry, he has it.
I wonder if it's going to go the whole distance, though.
Is it on the album or is it on the single?
Album, for sure. Well, I mean, yeah, here we go. Turn it louder.
How you feeling, bro?
It's just funny to listen to all those dorks chanting.
Yeah, we got bullied, dude.
So awesome.
That would, if I fell asleep to this album, that would fuck with me. Yeah. I'd wake up and be like, I don't like this anymore.
Oh yeah. Now Lewis talked about that. If you can go to untitled track of this album, it was track 99.
Yeah.
So if you did fall asleep to it and you wake up in 2 hours to this.
And because by the way, your CD player would just keep going like 34.
Track 99,
36. Yeah, no, fuck that. I'd beat the shit out of my boombox with a baseball bat.
I've fallen asleep to this CD before when I was younger, and no shit.
Yeah, dude, I'll wake up fighting. I will wake
up
fighting.
By the way,
it
shows you what's
terrified.
Funny. Marilyn Manson, like, strikes people. It's like, you know, I know the whole thing is, like, evil, dark, whatever. And I told you, I still don't watch horror movies before I go to bed or anything like that at all.
Look at a picture of you imagining listening to this.
Go to sleep on
little kids. This is your calling.
Significant years later. Yeah.
This evil.
Take your warm blanket. Satan is your blanket.
Satan is your Argyle sweater.
He wants you.
The devil likes smart bow ties.
But here's the thing. I found this to be more.
Even
like,
as an adult, I'm like, I don't like it.
Yeah,
I still find his music to be angry or sad, not like scary.
Yeah, I.
Does that make sense?
I find it to be scary.
This is very spooky stuff, guys.
This is RL Stine Goosebumps scary.
This is spooking me out right now.
Really?
I'm fucking high, dude. This is spooky stuff, dude. You're trying to invoke spirits in here?
But look at a little picture of me, little fat neck Jay in a bow tie.
Yeah. But then it's you speaking in Sanskrit.
You would never tell behind that bow tie.
I don't
like
any of this. No thanks. Dude, I don't like this now, and now we're controlling it. By the way, I wonder if there's an audio engineer that's like, hey, can you not do this? The guy making the album's like, hey, dude, can you just finish this on your own?
You want to go over that track again?
But I'm saying,
did you summon a demon in the studio right now, Marilyn?
But I'm saying to argue that the music is not like that thing. I mean, Lunchbox, exactly. I mean, the lyrics are all like, you bullied me and I'm going to come back and really just I'm gonna murder everyone you love and know.
I mean, they never did, dude. They never got me. I fucked them up. They would go listen to that. Didn't take.
Dude.
Didn't take for them.
Yeah, Shane stormed the beaches of nerdom.
He goes, you pick your targets, guys who couldn't figure out pipe bombs.
Yeah.
He goes, this fucking gonad? Not a chance.
He goes, I was lucky I did a lot of bullying before the Anarchist Cookbook came out. he'd be missing a wheel right now. Just be walking around with a prosthetic leg. He goes, some nerdy kid blasted out my feet when I got out of my car senior year.
Oh, these are the lyrics I have tattooed on me, this song.
Everyone will come to my funeral.
Yeah, I did go ahead and get one set of lyrics tattooed.
To make sure that I stay dead. Everyone will come to my funeral to make sure I stay dead.
That was not the lyrics.
That's not the lyrics.
I was going to say, do you want me just to go to your funeral and hold you down?
Have you not heard where he sings the lyrics that I have?
No.
No, you got to skip ahead to it, Christine.
It's lit.
Don't make me listen to the whole goddamn song.
Oh, dude, I bet Roman listens to Marilyn Manson while he fucks.
Bomb-ems.
Yeah.
Woo. Keep going.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. Sierra Sky. I bet we could bond over being scared about Marilyn Manson together.
She'd be so spooked right now. I'd fucking cuddle with her. I'd be like, dude, don't worry about it, baby girl. I fucking got you. I'll kill you, though. If a ghost comes in here, I'll fucking kill it. And you. I'll kill everyone.
I love you so much. And you go, don't worry, I bullied these people.
I took care for you, baby. Don't worry, I punched that evil son of a bitch.
Can I touch your butt?
Right in his fucking bat-winged heart.
Oh, yeah.
Good, yeah. Hell yeah.
Yeah. That's how I feel.
Just Marilyn Manson lyric. I get asked about it a lot. Like, yeah. Just Marilyn Manson lyric. It's like, sick, I don't have though. A cool story.
Yeah. Pretty sick.
Good lyrics.
I'm probably going to get the ND logo at some point. College football is significantly cooler than Marilyn Manson.
Yeah, everyone knows that.
And then Shane will bully me.
Yeah, and he's going to be like, are you sad? You're going to go in your fucking car and listen to music?
Jeez, you can go
like,
fucking, stop. You can go wuss out outside, you're punch
gonna,
air.
You're going to go to Jones Beach and hide from lightning? You puss. You're going to go hide from the lightning? God, you're such
you're
a pussy.
Hide from the storm. You're going to go hide from you're lightning just, and thunder?
I'm going to go fight it.
We have Shane here today for the unveiling of an offering. What else do you call it?
I mean, a temptation. I just want to say real quick.
From the fine people, it cheats themselves.
Wow.
Yeah.
Don't talk about Wawa. Wawa hasn't acknowledged this at all.
Let's. You want to open this up?
You mentioned Sheet's name next to
oh
you
Oh, my
know.
God. It's the head of Nikki Glaser.
Holy shit.
They sent a message.
They did it.
They sent us in a pack where the note that says, sorry, this isn't more official yet. I would have sent some boneless wings or popcorn chicken over, but I'm guessing you probably don't have a deep fryer in the studio of your offices. He's right. But we are working on that.
Damn, dude.
We'll figure something out. We'll figure something better out soon. In the meantime, I'll keep those packages coming with different food. In this package, here's what we have right here.
This is
and Shane, break this down if you know these things here.
Yeah, Shane, what are these?
Those are your I'll typical tell
you,
sauces.
I mean, I have the list here of what they are, so I can tell you. But you can tell us what if these things are good, you tell me, Shane. There's reverse chocolate chip cookies.
Yeah, there we go.
They are good. You can see them.
It looks good.
I've never had one. You can see it, though.
White chocolate macadamia nut cookies.
Great choice.
Phenomenal.
Reese's peanut butter cup cookies.
Fuck
Shut
you. Phenomenal.
Oh, God. Let's all get fat together and mush.
Pepperoni rolls that need to be heated up in the oven or toaster oven.
Pepperoni
Fuck that.
Rolls.
I mean, those are going to be unreal.
Eat those pep rolls straight out of the garbage bag that they mailed them to us.
What's this?
That's ice. The way to keep it cold. Dan's never seen things.
Ice is cool.
And here's the three other things they sent, Dan, to answer your question. There's jalapeno ranch.
Yeah.
Wow.
Sauce. There's Boom Boom Sauce, that's their thing. That's
Boom
that's,
Boom Sauce,
which
dude.
He says
is this, this Boom Boom, obviously.
That's the go-to.
I don't want to, by the way, there's secret recipe next to Boom Boom Sauce that I'm not going to read out loud what it is.
Wait, they got it in there?
It just says, he says more or less what it is.
And
it's sort of like going, like if someone goes McDonald's secret sauce, and you go, it's basically thousand.
Yeah. What's this?
That's got to be the secret, right?
No, do you know what that is? At
barbecue.
All? What kind? I'll tell you what kind.
Hickory.
Spicy Dr. Pepper barbecue.
Okay. You know what? Wow. Sheets, it's been nice doing business with you, but you take your circus fucking flavors out of here.
What'd you just say, dude?
You ever have Jack Daniel's sauce, Dan?
Kidney shock from Shane. Oh, God, he got me. He's got a blade on him.
Try it first.
Did you, Dan, did you ever have Jack Daniel's sauce from Fridays?
Yeah.
I'd fucking eat your dick with that.
Yeah, me too. You want to do that?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I knew we were going to get. Look at all these. Look at all these. Dude, I'm going to have so many cookies tonight.
By the way.
You guys get cookies. Don't think camera people
are going to
cookies.
This is sent to us, and you're going to love this. This is sent to us from Alex Hawk, who I know is a camper, an awesome guy.
I mean, this is.
Do you want to know his title, Dan?
What?
MTO Culinary Research and Development Manager.
Research and Development is reaching out to us.
Which, by the way.
Where the fuck you at?
I don't know if you know this, Dan. That means we know the guy, at least, who's next to the guy who could greenlight.
A bonfire sandwich
of some sort.
Yo, look at all. I mean, I just got cookie. This is
Sheets.
It's a rap
no, we
video.
Appreciate you,
dude. If you guys get a bonfire sandwich, that'll be my low point. I'll, like, if I in the future quit comedy, and I'm just out of Mechanicsburg paying for a bonfire Sheets burger by myself,
and they go like this. They go, and the guy's buying. He goes, "Hey, crackle crackle," and you go, "Just take the change."
He should be like, "How's Finnegan?" But Finnegan's fucking dead, dude.
What's Christine
I'm
just
eating? Out here?
No, he doesn't know who you are. Yeah. Like,
you guys got
beetle.
Cookies, motherfuckers.
Yeah, look at these, dude.
Well, throw me one. Stop talking about it.
Well, I'm trying to get it.
Can you put some Dr. Pepper barbecue sauce on mine?
Here. I'm going to give you a white macadamia.
I don't want that. Stop trying to give everybody out. I see what you've already given out. It's the bullshit you don't want.
No, I got to go
white macadamia. I'm going to kick it across the room to him.
Stacks. Thank you.
There's so many options right now. This is just.
Go on, throw me white macadamia.
I go, look, go on. I go, Jay, look, another white macadamia.
Ooh, I think these are all yours. You can have all these.
Wow.
Oh, hey, also, I got one that tastes like cough medicine, it says. Here, also take that.
Oh, cool. Look, this is the one. This is the diet Snickers.
Mmm. It's a good dense cookie. They know what they're doing.
Great texture.
Welcome to the family, Sheets.
Mm-hmm. Look at McPants throwing us a
double
shot. Campers, by all means, send in your kid pictures. It always makes us laugh.
Mm. Yeah, send us kid pictures.
Yeah. Hey, Falcone sent one, a No Doubt, a picture of her in a No Doubt thing not too long ago of her being little.
That's pretty adorable. At Gmail. All the kids, especially if you're in a bathing suit.
Tell your mom. Don't tell your mommies or daddies or we're both going to be in trouble. Just send it. Come on, you're big now.
Dude, Boom Boom Sauce.
That's the sauce, dude.
I kind of want to take this home.
That's not Boom Boom.
Oranges.
That's jalapeno ranch.
This jalapeno ranch?
Yeah.
I kind of want to take this Boom Boom home. Black Lou, how do we split it between the two of us?
Oh, no, you...
Nah, I mean, I got to go do spot.
You ain't split no sauce with
you
a black
take
man.
It. I just wanted to taste it.
Yeah, well, I mean, I would like to take it home, but I imagine you have to keep it cool. Mm-hmm. And I have to go do spots, so I can't. I can bring these cookies with me.
You want me to take it? You got it later?
No.
It's well, I don't know about here, gay.
Yeah, Dan, me and Christine will be your camel.
Cool, dude. I know facetiousness when you say it.
Being a sheet sauce mule is actually a pretty respectable profession where I'm from. I've held many sheets bottles for people. There's nothing wrong with being a sheets mule.
I try too, right?
Sheets mule.
Oh, Mr. Big Shit thinks being a sheets mule is all of a sudden not an honest way to make a living.
And he goes, hey, I'm sorry, you haven't been home in a while.
The flip chocolate chip cookie is
unbelievable.
Pretty impressive. I'm going to do what Jacob said. I'm going to try a little bit of this barbecue sauce. You think it's like Cosby's barbecue sauce? Does it get the ladies all hibby-jibby?
Oh, is that what he said?
Oh, something like that, right?
What'd you think?
Find Bill Cosby.
Fantastic.
Find Bill Cosby defends rape on Cosby Show. My barbecue sauce.
Oh, I know what you're going to be.
Yeah,
he's
don't
like,
you
that's all it takes.
Everybody gets a little drop my bum, and they get all hibbity-jibbity.
Yeah.
And then so I rape them.
It's just and then
I'm going to rape them as soon as they eat that sandwich.
You know, they fall asleep. I take sex from them.
I'm going to trick her into drinking that. I'm Bill Cosby. I'm a raper.
Hey, Bill, this seems real raw. Do you want to massage the language a little bit?
Nah, I feel like this barbecue sauce could be used in a marinade or just straight up.
Dude, Black Lou just took a shot of it.
Black Lou, I swear to you, I'll give you $20 right now if you just fucking chug.
He just did that.
Chug it like a 40?
He just went back and
did
took
really?
A shot.
Did you
really? Like a 40?
No shit.
I mean, yeah. I'm going to try this white.
You're not one of those slam dunking kinds. You drink like it's
wait,
40.
Wait, do we have a brown paper bag we can wrap it in first? I want to wrap it and have him chug it. Yeah.
Culinary development.
Play the background. Though. You know what's up with the barbecue.
I can see them work things
Dan.
Out for themselves.
Hey, Dan.
Oh, no.
You want to try the barbecue sauce?
It's my barbecue sauce.
You want to try Dan's barbecue sauce?
It's my barbecue
is there a peanut
sauce.
Butter cup cookie?
I was about to break into one. You want to? Yeah. I'll go halves on
oh,
one.
If you could find a way to reach into Dan's bag and grab it out, that'd be great.
It's white chocolate macadamia, dude. I've been handing out the macadamia. Yo, I'm about to flip out. Yeah, you guys are nuts.
Yeah, dude, chill, dude.
Dan, you're too hyped up.
Dan, dude, chill, bro.
Dan, you're too wired up. Why don't you try a little bit of my barbecue sauce?
I got one.
You know you try the barbecue sauce, yeah. Get all hibbity-jibbity.
I'm going to do a key bump.
Play it.
I got a cup of it, I said. Left it up there breathing. Why don't you give the chicken to these people that's going up and
back
have
it up.
Some sauce?
So here's the...
Your
barbecue sauce.
My barbecue sauce. You don't notice it at all. People have some of my barbecue sauce. After a while, when it kicks in, they get all huggy-buggy.
Huggy-buggy.
I'm dead serious.
This is what he thought being romantic was.
Yeah.
They were like, now you act like this is a sexual scene. And they're like, all right, maybe a little less rapey. Being real rapey.
Hey, Bill. You know how many karate chops of the carotid artery I've saved with my barbecues?
Hey, Bill, we were over in Video Village. Come comes off real rapey what you say to your wife. I just want to know if you're, I mean, it's your show. But
we saw you with an eyedropper over a Crafty trying to put something on all of the crispy treats.
That's my barbecue sauce. That ain't nothing. That's just how I fuck.
Just trying to get, you know, it's last day of shooting this week. I'm trying to get everyone huggy buggy.
On Friday evenings, I like to be the Zamboni and clean up all the dead bodies around Crafty. I come through and I make sure the ice is smooth.
It's time for our second. We have to take our second break.
Yeah, but I want to keep eating cookies.
Well, that's what better time?
Do you got to leave?
Yeah, I can.
It's until 8, right?
Yeah, what time is it?
It's only 7:05.
Oh, yeah. Well, fuck, dude. I guess I'll leave, dude, if you fucking want me to.
Dude, later, dude. I'm more cookies.
This is all good. Dude, I brought you this. I laid this. I laid this fucking. Look at what I brought
I
to you.
This tight.
I delivered this upon your feet, dude. I laid this. Cookies and sauces from Mechanicsburg at your table is what I bring to you. You're going to fucking kick me out? I got fucking dudes in Altoona mailing you cookies and you're going to fucking shit on me? Yeah. Altoona dudes. Yeah.
No, Shane, hang out as long as you can. We're going to take our next break. We'll be right back. This is The Bonfire. We all know you're never going to get as much sleep as you want. I mean, I always want 12 hours. What I end up getting, sometimes 6, sometimes 7, you know, mostly 8. So you have to make every hour of sleep you get count. Boll & Branch is going to help you finally get what you really deserve. A great night's sleep with a set of their 100% organic cotton sheets. Softest sheets you ever feel, right, Jay?
Yep. Isn't that right? If you want to sleep for 6, 7, 8 hours.
Yeah, dude. Hey, man, sometimes I want to sleep for 12 hours, but I sleep for 6, 7, or 8 hours. And they get softer over time. They're twice the quality of other luxury sheets for half the price.
You can, I mean, literally through time.
Through time.
It feels softer from hour 6.
7.
All the way up to 8.
Well, good news is three U.S. presidents sleep on Boll & Branch sheets, and that's the 6th president.
7th, 8th president.
8th president.
Some general you've never heard of.
Some guy that I think took it in a coup.
You can also Harding?
Yeah, you can try them in your home risk-free for a month. Plus, Boll & Branch has award-winning blankets, towels, and pillows that are all just as comfy as their classic sheets. So order today, or in 6, 7.
Just Jacob panic makes me laugh.
Order today and get $50 off your first set of sheets with promo code BONFIRE. It's $50 off BollandBranch.com with promo code BONFIRE, spelled B-O-L-L and branch.com, promo code BONFIRE, 678.
And now, back to The Bonfire with Big Jay Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Marilyn Manson B-sides. called Major Grotesque.
Yeah.
It's a good album. It's Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95, Big Jokers and Dan Soder, Shane Gillis joints. Shane Sheets Gillis joints.
Let's do it.
Oh, dude, Christine warmed up some of the pepperoni.
Oh, really?
Man. Motherfucking pep rolls fresh out of the mic.
I just want to say for the record, I want to say before we try these, I want to be fair to Sheets and say we were told to toaster, oven, or oven. They did not say microwave. I worry about how it's going to come out.
Do you think this is going to greatly affect how you judge them?
I might judge harshly.
Look at all these cookies, though. God, we have so much.
Christine went to go cook.
What a bountiful expedition.
You going to put a little boom boom sauce on your thing?
Oh, hell yeah.
Are you really? That doesn't sound like a good idea. I don't think that's what it's for.
Boom boom and pep might not mix.
Yeah,
you're living dangerously, but that's what Cheese is all about, is innovating and expanding. This is the type of attitude that'll get you into Altoona.
I'm sorry, I'm a creative type.
Well,
it's the Silicon Valley of gas station food.
It literally tastes like the stromboli I make.
Yeah.
That's a compliment. I make a mean-ass stromboli.
It's good.
It's good.
Sheets.
You know, it's good.
Sheets? I think you might be looking at a new member.
You're just jumping over.
Of Sheets Nation. I mean, we're having this conversation.
I'm going to jump over.
I'm going to jump over.
Wow.
I mean, we move as a family. We all know that. We move as a family. And we're a Wawa family. Well, no. Now we're in between people.
Just sending these in alone.
What the sauces? I mean, from the research and development sector, that's like,
it's just people who give a shit.
Dude, there's guys in camouflage lab coats right now working so fucking hard to figure out how to get the new pep roll out.
There's someone right now busting his ass in rural Pennsylvania, deep in a lab.
Guys, how about two cheeses? I'm sorry, I'm just the janitor here, but no.
No, say, that's interesting you say that. What's your name? How long? Derek? Derek, come here. How long you been here? Oh, not long. I was a Sheets mule for 10 years.
And why don't you tell me how a fucking boom boom sauce mule can come in here and work as a custodian and have better ideas than you, Rick? Why don't you tell me how that's possible?
He's like, this is a Goodwill Hunting, but with sandwiches that'll kill you.
They won't kill you.
What?
Shut your fucking mouth about that. Don't say it again.
For real, though, you guys have to make the switch now. This is pretty... Look at this.
It's good.
It's obvious what's happening here. One doesn't give a fuck. The one that was there in front of your face this entire time does.
This is like a rom-com with gas station sandwiches.
I'm just a boy standing in front of a convenience store sandwich.
Yeah.
Wawa's, saying I love you.
Wawa's the pretty rich girl that wants nothing to do with us, and then Sheets is just the best friend that's been in there the whole time.
Kiss me, yeah. Down by the beer,
yeah. Or he goes, Sheets goes like this. Sheets goes, I don't know. I know I got to go to writing camp this summer, but
he'll hold you in here.
Sheets like, yo, what are you doing, dude? Come over. Why don't you come over behind this dumpster, dude? I got pep rolls. I'll fuck you. I ended up raping you. My bad.
Sheets is like, want me to gobble you in the parking lot? Why don't you gobble me in the parking lot?
Yeah, don't finger me with your fucking greasy hands.
Hey, wipe your hand off on your jeans before you go for
that's
it.
That's Wawa, dude. Yeah, Wawa's out there.
There's a lot of oil.
I'm going down to shore. We ain't talking anymore. Fuck you. And Wawa's like, yo, dude. Fuck that bitch. I saw you talking to that bitch earlier. Come over here.
Yo, do you like video games?
I got cookies for you.
I got so many cookies and sauces.
I'm going to FedEx some cookies over to you. Where do you live? What's your address?
Can I mail sauces to you?
Jacob. Did you try one of these yet? Jacob.
I'm not either, but
we have to make a decision on who we're going to put our heart into.
It's a family decision.
Wait, you haven't tried one of these?
Yeah.
Oh.
It was fantastic. I tried one.
Jacob.
Jacob.
I'm sure it's great. I can't eat one right now.
Why?
Well, that's not a good way to do business.
Did you say you had Wawa?
No.
I'll fucking put you through a fucking window, dude.
No,
I'm a fool. I had Wawa. I left the city to get it.
I will fucking fire you through this plaster.
Dude, Jacob's got a set of broken ribs from Shane.
You want to find out what Studio 4 looks like?
Yeah, he goes, oh my God, he just commandoed him through the wall.
Holy shit.
Yeah, that's crazy. He just wouldn't try a pepperoni roll. And Shane just went
Outlaw Country 90, whatever.
Yeah. Shane went full left tackle and just blasted him through the wall.
Why can't you have a piece, Jacob?
I can't. I'm just...
Give a bite?
Don't take a bite.
No,
I don't want it. Business.
Just to eat.
Oh, you're bad at business. You're bad at business, dude.
That's not a good feeling.
I'm sure it's great. The cookies are great. The sauce is great.
So you had a cookie.
Not enough.
Did everybody else try the pepperoni roll?
I didn't get to try the peanut butter cup cookie. Is there one of those?
Oh, yeah, of course. How are you?
Yeah, it goes really good if you're just eating pepperoni roll.
Yeah, good. I mean, you want heartburn
something
immediately?
Sweet.
Or
get this out of my mouth. I only took one cookie. You want to get hurt? Well, I think Shane just dipped his cookie in the oil.
Yeah. Shane just took boom boom sauce.
Yeah, peanut butter cup boom boom sauce. Jalapeno ranch.
I'll tell you this. Bad for the reflux, great for the taste buds.
Yeah.
What is?
I'm getting some real chest heat right now.
Pepperoni roll?
Yeah.
I was going to fire back up on you, buddy.
I fired down two of those things. I'm breathing acid.
That's
right
why now. I had one little slice there because I'm like, it's going to.
Wow.
I got greedy quick.
I got to do a.
It kicked back up pretty goddamn fast.
I got to do a podcast and a stand up show after this. So I'm like,
I'm going to be doing a benefit fucking just burping. I'm going to be like.
One of those is like 10 Slim
Jims. Huh?
They put 10 Slim Jims into each one of those.
Yo, man, don't pull the curtain. Pull the sheet.
Yes.
Oh, I'm glad you guys are talking, because seriously, I'm dealing with a lot of fucking...
It's hurting you right now.
I'm getting through it.
You want a glass of milk?
I would love one. Do you have one?
Maybe
milk upstairs.
Yeah, I got milk on me.
I don't know.
Why
are you going around offering glasses of milk if you ain't got one on you, dude?
Well, Christine went upstairs to prepare pepperoni rolls. I'm sure she'll make a milk run.
You got sweet bottled water, dude.
That's not going to help. That makes things worse. You know that.
No, it cuts right through it.
This jalapeno sauce is a good base.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's a great base after you have pepperoni rolls.
You want to eat that ass?
He goes, as Winston Churchill once said, when going through hell, keep going. Take a shot.
Jalapeno Rancho hit the spot.
He goes, go all the way through.
He goes, has Sheets got the cure for what ails you?
Yeah.
Take a little swig of that right there.
Just put gas on the fire.
Wait, did we get an official? Black Lou took a swig of barbecue sauce. Did you give a review overall?
What'd you think?
Honestly?
Yeah.
It's very nice.
Ooh.
Definitely a white
God.
Guy in the kitchen put that together.
A white guy in the kitchen.
Oh, how dare you.
Very good,
basically,
though.
You know what he's saying? He's saying there's no soul in that barbecue sauce.
It was a white guy, but while he was cooking, he was going, Mama's in the kitchen cooking. Hey,
yeah,
Mama's
racist.
In the kitchen cooking.
He was racist as fuck when he made it.
Yeah.
That's got to count for some soul.
You can't taste a little bit of the hate in that? Yeah. There's just a guy pounding on a door to get in. He's going, what? As he's making the sauce.
He goes, take this out to the workers and have them tell me they think it's good. The white workers.
Because the ones that drive trucks.
The yellow one's amazing, though.
Yeah, the yellow one.
Boom boom sauce.
Boom boom sauce is good, and I like this, the ranch combo.
Christine, you're a sauce person. Boom boom sauce good?
I've not tried the boom boom or the barbecue.
You love what boom boom sauce is. You know what boom boom...
Can I try it?
You love what it is. Ingredients wise, Dan can't figure out what boom boom sauce is.
Shut your mouth, dude! I nailed it.
It's pretty easily color coded.
Delete the footage.
It looks like
from me grabbing the wrong one.
Chili garlic sauce mixed in with mayonnaise.
You're guessing that by look?
Yeah.
No.
What are you, a detective? She goes, "This sauce died 5 days ago."
It tastes like that's what it is too.
What? She goes. There was a struggle when the sauce was made. I could taste it.
It would be great if Christine nailed that.
Goes, I saw the peppers.
There was divorce in the air.
She goes, one of them was jealous. The other one tried to run. This sauce is
he
right.
Goes, it ended in a murder-suicide.
Wow.
That's all true.
I go, what? I mean, how did you know
goes,
that?
One bullet to his wife.
Goes,
one bullet to his own head. Hence the name. Boom, boom.
Yeah. He goes, oh. And it also pairs well with a turkey sandwich.
It's also
ordered on a computer.
Dealing with reflux? I got the cure for what ails you.
Oh, dude. I mean, Sheets is going to be...
That reflux? There's nothing, dude.
Reflux
that's,
Nation?
You just got a small case of Sheets gut.
Sheets gut.
That happens to the best of us.
You got
2 liter Mountain Dew, put that down. Get some citrus, skull. Get some skull.
Oh, take it to the face, dude. Yeah, dude. Take it to the face.
Yeah, he goes, ah, dude, I don't even know what you're doing. A whole bag of Tasty Cakes, mini donuts.
Mountain Dew probably, to some degree, flushes you out.
Oh, yeah. I think what it does, it's like chlorine in a pool. It just keeps everything clean.
Burns your eyes.
Yeah, like, too much Mountain Dew in your system. Like, ah, I opened my eyes while I was drinking Mountain Dew, and now they're all red.
Your eyes are all spider webs with bloodshot. You're like, oh. Yeah, dude, I just cranked in a dew.
Dude,
I almost canoed here on dry land.
He goes, I took a code red to the dome. Extreme! affects fertility. Oh, they're saying the dye in Mountain Dew, it's a theory.
Well, that's what, yeah, we use that. I'm sorry, it affects fertility. That's plan B where I'm from. You've nutting a chick.
Do?
If you nutting a chick, you're like, we got to get some cold, cold Mountain Dew to knock that fucking kid right out.
You should do a thing where you make her squat over it and drop a couple Mentos in it and kind of fire up into her.
You go,
this is where we're headed with Roe v. Wade.
Let's go to Delco.
This is where we're headed.
Let's go to Delco abortion.
He goes, oh, Delco plan B? Wait, Mountain Dew, or you just birth an X Games athlete if the kid survives?
Yeah! He goes, I just want to thank my mom and my dad for making me with a liter of Mountain Dew and their love.
The kid air guitars out of his mom's cooch while doing the Angus Young step.
He goes,
what's up? My name's Colby, and I'm ready to do backflips on a 50cc dirt bike.
Producer Jacob always distracts me. He's like, we can't talk about AC/DC like that. He just storms off.
We can't? You got to leave?
Just needed to mark.
Something. No, I know. I'm just saying, whenever he gets up, he always, Jacob never gets up like, this is fun so far. I got to go do something. He always goes, it's always like, shit, there's a problem.
You know what he does? He gets up like a parent where a little kid grabs something, where he goes,
down, hey.
Yes, exactly.
Owen?
You see it. You're in the eye line, right? I'm always like, what's going on? We said something wrong?
I always think he's mad at me.
Yeah. I just want it warmer in the fucking studio. I was just trying to pull something.
You can't talk about Angus Young coming out of a pussy, man. Because that guy's the lead.
Jacob, why are they doing this to you, dude?
I don't know. It was actually the opposite. I'm marking something very funny for a promo.
Oh, okay.
He goes, on sheets day you're going to do this?
On all
on
the days.
On sheets day?
On our sheets confirmation day.
This is. What's your new confirmation name? Rusty.
Daryl.
Yeah, for sure.
My sister tried to take Shaniqua. At our Catholic confirmation, she was like, Shaniqua. Like, Chantel. And the priest was like, there's no fucking Saint Chantel.
Yeah, there is. The Saint's a nail salon.
Chantel. I want Dan used to be Dennis. I want to be Kenneth.
You're going Kenny?
Kenny.
Kenny's a good sheets confirmation name. That's powerful. Yeah.
Kenny, and if you're going Kenny, I want to go Daryl.
Daryl's sick.
Okay, yeah, Daryl's not
actually,
a bad one at
all. Man, should our confirmation names be Buck and Oscar?
Oh, yeah, Buck and Oscar. Yeah, for sure.
My dad wanted to name me Buck, and his dad wanted to name him Oscar.
Oscar Oakerson. He was going to send a fat kid in the world with double O.
Oscar Oakerson.
Yeah, man, your dad almost really set you up for being a life of fucking. You'd be the toughest human being on the earth. You'd be like it's like a boy named Sue.
Oh, dude. Yeah, I have fucking a tattoo from my neck to my forehead.
Oh, dude, you'd start off with double O, then Oscar the Grouch. Man, you would have been dragged through the dirt.
Oh, I would have been the meanest kid in the world.
There was a super heavy set black kid in my school named Oscar. That's all he went through. But it was Oscar Brown. It was
two Oscars?
Good last name. Oscar Oakerson. It just sounds like it sounds like words you could say with tuba notes.
And Buck Soder is the name of a young father.
Buck Soder for sure carries a knife in his boot.
And he has a kid at 14.
Definitely. Yeah, yeah. You drove way young. Yeah. Everything was too young for you.
My dad would let me drive when I was 11. Take the truck out. You got to leave.
I got to get the fuck out of here, boys. Yeah.
Got to head back to Sheets Nation.
Shane Gillis, everybody.
You guys are the best.
You know him from the show Fair Ones, which you're going to go do right now.
Yeah.
Over on the Anthony Cumia Network.
Or Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast.
Ooh.
Gang, 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 dude. Sheets Nation. Shout out Finn. Shout out Zeus. Yo, we out here. Jacob, I'll fucking suck your dick. All right.
Bye.
Shane Gillis, everybody. Let's take our last break. We'll come back and take this thing all the way to 8 p.m. Eastern.
Eastern, not Pacific.
It's the bonfire.
Oh, man. There's pep rolls.
I've got dinner plans for you, but it doesn't involve a restaurant or takeout or even grocery shopping. It's just sitting down to enjoy an easily prepared, delicious home-cooked meal. And that's what you get with HelloFresh. HelloFresh, one of our newest sponsors. Simple recipes. Fresh, pre-measured ingredients delivered right to your door. No more searching for mystery items at the store or dealing with leftover ingredients. No extra waste. No difficulty. No having to go buy one little garlic clove because you need garlic. It's just simple recipes, pre-measured. No more searching. You just have to Go to HelloFresh.com. Choose from a variety of recipes across veggie, classic, and family plans. Then your meals arrive with easy-to-follow full-color instructions. With HelloFresh, you can whip up dinner in 30 minutes or less. And guess what? There's a lot of one-pot recipes for speedy cooking and minimal cleanup. After 2 or 3 weeks of HelloFresh, you'll love your new dinner routine because of how simple and fun it is to cook and enjoy delicious home-cooked meals. For a limited time right now, you'll get $30 off your first box at HelloFresh.com/comedy. Plus, you'll get free shipping. That's HelloFresh.com/comedy for $30 off. HelloFresh.com/comedy.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Guess his esophagus feels great.
Yours?
This guy.
Dan Soder.
Old Milky Dan.
Sitting across from me, Jay Okerson.
Oh, hot sauce Jay.
I tell you what, I like making you happy and the happiness on your face. First, it was disbelief. It was a lack of trust and not believing what I was saying and thought maybe I was angling for something to get around you.
Mm-hmm.
But when I said, you're like, you want to take any of these cookies home, Jay? And I was like, no, you could have the cookies, so it's fine. You were like, what the fuck's up?
Mm-hmm.
What's going on? You're going to try to get all of them, aren't you? And I'm like, no, I really don't want any of them. It's mm-hmm. fine. It's just, I don't know. But when you finally settled into this, when you saw you packing them up and everything mm-hmm. you were doing, and I wasn't saying anything about it, and you realized it was genuine, you've been pleased since then? Is that the right word?
I'm excited to eat these cookies tonight.
You're pleased. I like
very, very uncomfortable plane ride to Madison tomorrow morning, but
I like pleasing you.
Thank you. Thank you for pleasing me with your cookies.
I like to see you please.
This definitely sounds like truck stop lingo for two married men that are about to perform gay sex on each other.
The thing is, what we have to get from Sheetz, I don't know how we're going to do it.
Sandwiches, man.
Sandwiches. That's
we
a big
gotta
deal.
Know if the sandwiches are there.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, I really ate it.
Pepperoni roll was
unbelievable,
fucking delicious,
so good. Still burping it up.
Yeah. Christine giggled weirdly the whole thing.
We're
having odd reactions to that. Pepperoni roll was good.
Julie, put
was it?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Because I put pills in all of yours.
LSD, if you ate it, goodbye. If they, yeah, we got into sandwiches because Wawa sandwiches is what did it, but.
People love Shane. I love it.
He's giggling at Alpha Meathead.
Oh, yeah. Roger, notorious RGA, saying that his Kenny Powers / Alpha Meathead energy is the absolute
yeah. Yeah, because I like Shane. What's funny because we're all adults. I don't picture Shane a bully at all. But when he says it, you're like, oh yeah, totally.
If I was smaller,
this guy would just make fun. He's just probably always tall and kind of like lanky.
Yeah,
and just enough, you know, like a thick enough kid to like.
But I wonder,
you know, what I mean, like just talk shit to like.
But he's funny, which means that there had to have been kids that got him. They're like, shut up with your baby face. He's like, shut up.
No, they got him. The people that got him, whoever he was trying to impress, are the ones that got him.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean? Like, they probably laughed at his, because he was probably the funniest person making fun of these people.
Yeah.
And like, oh, we're also going to stuff him in the toilet. And he's like, sure.
He goes, I just want to make fun of him.
Yeah, but whatever, man. Yeah. I'm in. I mean, I'm on for the ride.
Kenny Powers energy is perfect.
It's perfect thing to describe.
Is your jaw still bothering you?
Yeah. I feel like there's a new muscle in my jaw that wasn't there before. And it hurts.
Stronger. Evolving. He's becoming.
Like, I feel like that muscle's not on the other side of my face.
What's this?
It looks like Shane in high school, but I can't make it big.
Oh, well, that shows you Shane's technology.
How good people were able to... People that went to school with Shane listened to the show, but no one went to school with me. I guess they're all dead because we're so old.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Hey, dinosaur.
Oh, I guess you guys have lives and don't listen to juvenile radio where we...
I have
chug
to find
barbecue sauce. Talk shit.
I have to find my. There's like yearbooks. I have yearbooks at my mom's house that I'll dig up.
By the way, go back to.
Yeah. One more.
No, one more. If that guy bullied you, you deserve to get bullied.
Yeah.
If that Shane.
I mean, I understand he's big, but you can just take him out with the knees.
Hey, I don't know if you saw Roadhouse recently, Dan, but.
I mean, do you want to talk about Roadhouse? Because I want to talk about it, but I want.
Did we not talk about Roadhouse at all yet?
We never talked about it.
No.
Ah, buddy. It's evergreen. Let's keep it. Let's save it.
Well, it's just an interesting point you brought up.
It's a very interesting. I'll bring it up right now.
Nah, let's wait. Let's wait to get into it because it's a long conversation.
I'm happy to bring it up right now.
I just don't feel like this is the time. And I also feel like I want to address the girl that lied to me. Shane looks like a young father. I never realized that.
I mean,
Shane's got young dad face.
He looks like Haley Joel Osment there.
Shane's got your dad is a kid face. You know, when you're like, oh, that's what dad looked like when he was 28? Weird.
It looks like when Jerry Mathers grew up, the beaver.
Yeah. I think, oh, boy.
Can you bring a picture of Jerry Mathers as an adult?
Jerry Mathers face. Everyone started calling Shane Jerry Mathers face.
Hey, Jerry Mathers.
Dude, that yesterday, so we were waiting for the lightning to pass in the concert. You know, we were still waiting. And finally, I told Jay, I was like, dude, I think I might try to get out of here before, if this thing's canceled. Because we heard 9:15, it went to 9:15. We heard 9:30, we heard 9:15. Finally, I was like, I'm going to go ask someone that works here. This girl is on her cell phone at a snack booth. That's old Shane Gillis.
No, but you gotta go to younger Jerry Mathers than that. Jesus Christ.
There's this girl. I mean, that's hilarious. You could say that Shane's dad.
He was a young beeve.
Young beeve, a.k.a. the young beeve. But there's like this teenage girl on her cell phone. And I walk up. I'm like, hey.
Behind the merch booth.
She's behind the merch booth. She's the manager. But she's no older than 19. Uh-huh. And I was like, hey. Do you know if the concert's going to get canceled? And she's like talking to her. She goes, no, they're going on at 9:30. And I go, they're going on at 9:30. And she goes, yeah, they're going on at 9:30. And I was like, cool. All right. You sure? And she goes, yeah. And I walked away. And then 10 minutes later, by the way, she said this at 9:25. They canceled the concert.
They're going on at 9:30. I go, they haven't announced anything? They're going on in 5 minutes?
Yeah. And I was like, oh, she lied to me.
But you wanted her not to be lying to you so much.
So bad.
That we all acknowledged it was ridiculous to tell you that with 5 minutes to go.
Yeah.
You didn't even start to feel the sting of maybe this was all horseshit until you looked down and he goes, well, 9:31, now I just feel like this girl was just fucking with me.
Yeah.
Yes, Dan, she was clearly from the get-go. She told you, I would have said, 5 minutes from now.
Yeah.
She's like, yeah, totally.
Hey, dude, I wanted to walk back over there and be like, hi, Miss Dan Soder, professional comedian. Great job. That was well played.
Watch, ask me what time show starts.
Hey, do you know, is the show going to start up soon? Or
Oh, yeah, real soon. What time do you want it to start?
Probably, I don't know, like... Now?
Yeah. It starts now. Now they're going on.
What? Okay, now, how's that possible? I'm sorry.
Sorry. I'm on the phone. Yes?
Did you say the show's starting now?
Yeah. When do you want it to start again?
I mean, not now or like 5 minutes?
Well, it makes more sense, would you say? Like, not now. Clearly not going on now. But yeah. I mean, like, hey, let me see. Yeah, I got some information. What was it?
Yeah. That's what Jacob and I kept doing. They heard going, no, this is Marilyn Manson on the phone. Yeah. Yeah. Now he says, go wait for him out in the rain. Yeah, no, push through the security. I'll let you get the front row. Yeah.
I said, you don't think this is Marilyn Manson? Holds it front to you. You want to talk to him?
Yeah. She goes, I don't know, some old guy. I'm all, hey.
Do the voice.
Here's
what's going on. Yeah, put him on right now.
Oh, you welcome to the show. I'd say take your seats now if you want me to get out.
Shane's got young. He's got the young beaver face.
Beave. Hey, young beave. Wow, Jerry Mathers Gathering.
I love Shane, but he looks exactly like a guy who used to beat the shit out of me in school, in high school.
That's really embarrassing.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was a lot. That was a big share, Jacob. Yeah. Thank you.
He used to be just for no reason?
Thank you.
Well, I mean, yeah.
Because you're...
I never spoke to him.
Really?
He's just this tall, angry guy. He was like, he would say something to me like, I bet you would spit on soldiers coming back from Nam.
What year are you in high school?
Fuck?
But that's what I'm saying. I was clearly nowhere. This was in the 80s. I don't know why you would even.
Was your dad John Fogerty?
Yeah.
The war was over for many years, but he would beat me up for
Vietnam?
Vietnam. Yeah.
What a weird way to bully a kid.
He was a maniac.
Yeah, dude. Mid-90s were rough. Some kid kicked the shit out of me because the Desert Storm. Because of the first Gulf War. For
the first Gulf War, this kid wound up. Not a big H-Dub fan, if you know.
He was very into the military.
I guess.
And so I wanted to try and just get him off my back. So I remember I said, he was talking about wanting to blow up.
Came back dressed like Rambo. You wore like a green army jacket. Yeah. He goes, hey, man, I feel your pain, brother.
He goes, I didn't know you were
back here. Can't even get an education without being bothered by some goddamn protester.
Education. Try getting a snack during a passing period.
He goes, you're right, brother.
He was racist as hell and hated every foreigner.
Oh.
So he wanted to drop a bomb on every country.
Oh,
and
cool.
So I just wanted to get this guy off my back and
Jesus.
And sort of bond with him just to. And I said, you drop a Hades bomb on him. And he said, you got that from Iron Eagle. And I took a pounding for that because he said, he realized I was trying to bond. The only bomb I ever heard of was the Hades bomb from Iron Eagle.
He beat you up
because of a sweet Iron Eagle reference?
It was a strong.
You know,
now
he's a copyright lawyer.
Yeah, he goes, by the way.
That's his job now.
You can't use that reference.
That's what he said. He beat the hell out of him for trying to use it. He goes, that's a reference from Iron Eagle. And then beat him up for making the reference.
He called me on that for referencing Iron Eagle, not knowing real bombs.
You should have written Louis Gossett Jr. a letter, and he would have shown up and set that guy straight.
Jacob's
maniac.
Sit down, Waldo.
Yeah.
He's like, that's the beginning of the Hot for Teacher Van Halen video. I don't like plagiarism.
But you know, in 3 o'clock high, he finally stands up and fights a bully?
Yeah.
Yeah, I never did that.
Yeah. You just sussed him out.
My brother did. Took a wild ass kicking. But I'll tell you what.
He stood up to the bully?
It does work. They'll never bother you again.
They'll bother you again.
But I didn't. Yeah, I didn't do it.
So your brother went at the bully, and the bully was just like, well,
after a while, I told him, I was like, dude, turn around. You're not a weak, he's a strong kid.
Yeah.
He's just very small.
Yeah.
I was like, just whail him first.
Yeah.
When they come to do the thing they're talking, I go, just give everything you got in that one. And you might get your ass kicked, but they'll never bother you, because they'll know they're going to have to fight you every time.
Yeah. And if
nobody bullies with the intention to fight.
No, they want
to
they want an easy win.
They want to have somebody shove them around that's afraid of them.
Jacob has a vast knowledge.
I never got
knowledge.
That speech. I think I would have done it if I could, but I never got the speech.
But you have a vast knowledge of sharks. If you punch a shark in the nose.
Your mom was like, get in here, booby.
I know that as an adult.
Come help me pet my doll's hairs.
She goes, oh, Jacob, tell me about your problems as we dress my dolls in their former wear.
Jacob,
Trish went like this.
Jacob, I said evening gown. Mm-hmm. That is not an evening gown. That is a cocktail dress.
She goes, I'm sorry. No. I thought these ladies were going out for a nice night, not trying to get fucked. Fights Jacob.
Now tell mama about these boys who are bothering you.
She goes, they're both just combing doll hair. And he goes, wow.
Stuart was at it again today.
She goes, tell me, baby.
My grandmother did the old, those kids across the street are bothering you, calling you fat, and telling you're going to go out there and sit on them.
That's right. Like,
that didn't make it me feel any better.
You go, well, so you go, so they're not wrong?
She's like, well, I'm glad you, I'm sorry you had to hear it from them. But then tell them now you're going to use that against them.
Trish told me in a very busy way while making dinner one time. She was like, just punch him in the mouth. I go, what?
See, I admire that.
She goes, just punch him in the mouth.
Yeah.
She goes, you'll see where it goes from there, but I bet it'll make you feel a lot better. That's the exact sentence she said. She goes, I bet it'll make you feel a lot better. Yeah. And I was like, yeah, probably will. And then I did, and then another kid punched me in the side of the head as I was fighting one other kid.
Sucks.
Ow. Yeah, it sucked. But, you know, then the cops showed up pretty quick. I think they were just in the neighborhood,
yeah.
And we had to do that scatter thing, but then the cop came up and was like, you guys all right? And none of us wanted to get in trouble, so we're like, yeah, we're just wrestling. It's got grass in my hair. I'm like...
I don't...
He goes, why do you have a loogie on that Notre Dame jersey? I go, what? Are you, a detective? I'm sorry, I thought you were a patrolman. I didn't realize I was dealing with murder police.
I didn't realize it was the top brass. I didn't realize this thing went all the way up the chain arm.
You're fighting for me. I'm sitting on a cop. Sorry, Columbo. You know... I take the DNA.
That's fucking hilarious. Wow. We got a regular Clouseau on our hands, huh?
Hey, Sherlock. Why don't you go get Holmes? Oh, fuck.
Oh, yeah.
Where's Watson?
Give me the sketch artist. I saw everything.
Yeah. Shouldn't you be cutting parking tickets, fucking dork? I don't know. We got to report kids
are there
fighting.
A black kid selling Lucy cigarettes somewhere?
You go. Don't you want
to deal with?
Don't you want to go bother someone with a darker shade? Fucking racist.
Oh, I'm sorry. I must not be wearing my t-shirt. It says it. I'm white. You can get out of here, man.
Yeah, I go. We pay.
Everything's fine.
My mom pays your bills.
There's no minorities need attacking here.
We're breathing awkward. He's like, all right, bye. We're like, bye.
You get it out there. He goes, there's no minorities need attacking here, sir. We don't need any problem.
You really forget how much, I mean, fighting takes all of it out of you. When you fight, when you actually get into a fist fight, you are fucking gassed. That's why all boxers do is run.
You know, Lewis was talking about it. We watched the UFC this weekend.
Yeah. Is Lewis doing the thing now that he's training and he's in the thick of it and the fight's coming up in a few weeks? Is he like...
Talking too technical? No. Yeah. Not technical at all. He was actually just saying about his win because his cardio, he's saying right now, is really, really good.
Yeah.
Justin, the Beastmaster, Silver backs that up. His wind is really good. But Lewis, and he's predicting it for both of them. If you just never done it before, he just goes, all the shit you're thinking is like the in-between that no one cares about. He's talking about hanging on the side of the cage.
Yeah.
I mean, I know because I've talked to enough inside people know this too, but all that on the, and they say it on the show if you listen, you know, on the actual broadcast, but all that cage jockeying for position, arm over arm, just kind of being braced for if they're going to throw knees or something, but all that hug up shit when they're standing up against the cage is just killing your wit. It's just, that's exhausting. Or trying to go to take somebody down and you don't get them.
Dude, if me and you
said, all the effort trying to take somebody down and, like, you know, they stuff it and you're like, gee, that was like, it's just so much adrenaline goes into those moves, and he was, so it's like interesting here, and I'm like, talk about, like, you know, this thing possibly going any kind of, it's only three rounds, but
yeah, but five minutes rounds.
I'm pretty sure I can say comfortably and confidently that I've never fought for five minutes.
Yeah, never.
Five minutes?
Never had a fight go over 5 minutes.
No way.
Ellis
five, Mania. Maybe 3 minutes sounds like long to me, honestly. Usually they're pretty quick.
Ellis Mania 14, August 25th.
15. This is 15.
This is 15. Oh, okay. It's coming up 2 weeks.
Yeah, man. It's going to be crazy.
August 24th through the 25th. Right?
Yeah. Is it 14th?
I
think it's 15.
I think it's 15, too.
Luis J. Gomez fighting Ryan O'Neal.
Yeah, 15. There it is. The joint at the Hard Rock Hotel. Jason Ellis, friend of the show.
Yeah, smoked Honey's own Luis J. Gomez.
Smoked Honey's Luis J. Gomez.
Fighting Ryan O'Neal from the O'Neal and Danish podcast.
Danish and O'Neal, yeah.
Danish and O'Neal. I'm going to stream it. I'm going to be in Philly.
Yeah, you can buy it, right?
Yeah, I'm going to be in Philly at Helium with Young Beav, Shane Gillis.
I'm going to be in Where is it? Madison.
Madison.
I'm going to be in Madison that weekend.
So what we need to do is we need to agree to not watch the fight. We should watch it on speakerphone together.
Later that night.
After the late show.
We have what I'd like to look into, and also to give us information to the listeners, can you stream it whenever you want?
That's big.
Or is it live only?
Because if it's live only, that could be a problem. Yeah. And I really want to watch this fight.
I'd like to buy it later.
Yeah. Saturday, August 25th.
It's going to be awesome.
Hard Rock Las Vegas.
I'm excited, man. I think Lewis has this.
Yeah. It's going to be interesting to see.
Dude, today flew.
Yeah. I mean, I'll tell you this. Actually, I got that heartburn. The show slowed down a little bit.
No, you've been fine. You got milk.
I got milk. Thank you, cows.
What a weird gathering of things you have around here.
Thank you, scientist.
Boom Boom sauce, cookie wrappers.
I live a very interesting life.
Coffee, tea, water, milk.
I'll tell you this. My life is filled with sauce and sweet.
It's like you opened a HelloFresh box that you have no clue what you're making.
I think this thing makes a pipe bomb. I don't know. I'm pretty sure.
Jalapeno ranch cookies?
You diarrhea? That's the only thing I can guess.
I thought it was going to make a problem in the morning.
I go, it's going to be a real soupy poop. that was what it's going to be.
Soup poop.
Soupy poop. Good Lost Tapes tomorrow?
Great Lost Tapes tomorrow.
I really want to do this Roadhouse thing, but that's going to fucking take at least 40 minutes to get through. So we'll do it on the Lost Tapes next week.
I think it'd be a good Lost Tapes one. I think so. Or it might be a good caller thing to point out other ridiculous storyline things.
Well, let's not go saying anything yet.
What?
I don't know. I think these pepperoni rolls are...
getting your brain?
Yeah.
No, I'm saying we're pointing out something in Roadhouse. It's a storyline point.
That makes
just
sense.
Not a storyline point. It's like a movie detail that's pretty in your face that no one seems to recognize, and I think people might have good examples of of that in other movies. So maybe we'll do it right on Monday, depending on how wet and wild it gets for you and Murkface.
Oh, me and Murkface in Madison, Wisconsin.
That's where you're going to be. Comedy on State this weekend, Dan Soder. And then after that, he's going to be at the Vermont Comedy Club in Burlington, Vermont. That's the 16th through the 18th. Dan Soder is on the road. Got an awesome poster that he's going to be selling at the shows. That's really, really awesome. You previewed it on the...
I put it on Instagram, at Comedy Artwork Made It. Brian, really great. Big J's going to be at the Laughing Skull in Atlanta August 16th through the 18th. Then he's going to be at Comedy on State, Madison, Wisconsin, August 23rd through the 25th. Go get tickets and the album. I promised myself I wouldn't ask. Volume 2 of the Crowdwork Sessions on Comedy Central Records.
Yeah, please check it out.
Go check that out. It's fucking hilarious. I downloaded it, listened to it. Love it.
I love it. I gotta make like a tour name or something.
You said that, and I was gonna name it, but then just the poster said Dan Soder Popinski.
The poster's great, but you could call it the Soder Popinski Tour.
Sure.
If you wanted to. But I mean, like, I just gotta do that at some point. Maybe I'll make like
my
next.
It's good for marketing.
Maybe I'll make the next calendar year or something.
Yeah.
Special. After the Netflix thing, I'll start calling it something else and put my dates on some sort of merch, be it a poster or something. I got to figure that out because that's great. I love that, man. And also, Best of the Bonfire, now a podcast. It's a show we air here on Sirius on Fridays. I know it sounds a little ridiculous to go listen to a podcast you can listen to on Sirius XM, but I'm asking you to tell people who do not have Sirius to listen to it.
Exactly.
I'm telling you to go there if you listen to us on Sirius and on demand every day and just let them know. They do not give us numbers here at all whatsoever. And Sirius has been good to us. Don Wicklin, they really came through for us big on this thing yesterday. I gotta say, but we need Comedy Central and everybody to know what's happening over here. And how good and how much you fans love it and how engaged you guys are and how much you want the show to keep going on and on, man.
And so, shout out to Sheets. Well played.
Sheets, very, very well played. We'll be talking to you soon. Wawa, you're on the clock.
Yeah, better make some moves, Wawa.
We'll be back Monday with a live show. Right, Jacob?
Monday, yeah.
Yeah, all right. Just trying to make sure you're still awake over there.
Seeing if you're still asleep.
And then, Jacob?
Yeah.
We'll be back Monday with a live show. Enjoy the Lost Tapes tomorrow. We love you, guys. I love you, Dan.
I love you, Jay. And God, I love these cookies.
Crackle, crackle. Till next time.